Hey guys, welcome to the video today. I'm Todd from Todd's Garage. We're gonna be doing a review on the TrusTech electric heater. The model number on this one is IFH17-02. I got this one off Amazon. It was about like $52 and some change after tax. There were a couple different options for me. I got a pretty good sized garage here. It's about 450 square feet. There was a lot of 1500 watt electric heaters to choose from, this is one of them. And if you went any bigger than that, most of the ones that I found that were larger than that needed 220 versus 110. And I don't have a 220 outlet in my garage, so I'm sticking with the 110 for now. The other option was to get a propane heater, and those were nice. They were a little more money. But from the reviews on this one, even though it's rated far less with how many square feet it can heat, the people in the reviews were saying that this heater could heat up a garage. So I wanted to give it a chance, put it to the test, see if it's going to work for me. It's been starting to get cold. Right now outside, it's like roughly 30 some degrees. And I'm going to need to heat it up quite a bit more in my garage if I'm going to be out here working on my arcade games and whatever else I have going on. So let's get this thing out of the box and take a quick look at it, and then we will get it hooked up, and we will see if it can heat up the garage. We'll do kind of a unboxing review all in the same video. So, okay, let's go ahead and open it up here. Okay. Okay, got an owner's manual here. All right guys, so here's the owner's manual. One thing I want you to do before you plug this in is make sure to read through this. There are tons of warnings, cautions, things that it wants you to be aware of before you plug this in and use it. So make sure that you read through this fully before you plug this thing in and use it. And they even got in any questions, send it to support at TrusTechProducts.com. Just make sure to read through this completely before you use it, so you understand all the warnings, and cautions and safety advice that they give you, before you use this. Okay, guys, let's get back to it. Got the warranty card. If you want to do an extended warranty, we will not. This was cheap enough. Take the styrofoam off here. So the one thing I can tell you right away is this is a lot smaller than it looked on Amazon. It's pretty small. Let's get it out of the bag here. Okay. Okay, guys, it has a fan mode. This is 750 watts. This is 1500 watts. And then this is the dial for, you know, how hot you want it to be. And then a power indicator light. I can tell you it's cute. I like the color on it for sure. One thing I wanted to point out too is that this swivels, so you can, you know, if you lift it up, it's too big, so if you try to do it while it's sitting, the bottom here rubs on the ground. But if you lift it up a little bit, you can swivel it, and it goes all the way, you know, point it straight up if you wanted to. That's a good feature, but you do have to lift it up. It doesn't want to do it while it's sitting on the ground because the bottom will hit against the ground while you're trying to do it. And then also, you know, it's got the carry handle here. It's really lightweight. And then this is like a roughly 6 foot cord. Well, let's go ahead and get it hooked up in the garage. Just leave it running for, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes and see if I can notice any difference in here. So I'll be back in a second once I get this hooked up. I'll show you what it looks like while it's on. We can see how loud it is. And then we'll just allow it to try to heat up the garage and go from there. Okay, be right back. All right, guys, I got it plugged in. Let's turn it up to the 1500 watt option. And I got it cranked all the way to full heat. And so you guys know, so 1500 watts is 1.5 kilowatts. In my area, I get charged like roughly 8 cents per kilowatt hour. That means that this is gonna cost roughly 12 cents per kilowatt hour to run. It's not horrible. Okay, so we got it cranked up as hot as it can go. I can already feel the heat coming out of it. It's really quiet. Let me bring you guys closer just so you can listen to it yourself. But yeah, it's not loud at all. Some small vibrations, probably just because it's so small and light. But yeah, let's give it 15 or 20 minutes and I'll come back in the garage here and I'll tell you know, what it feels like, how if we were able to warm this big garage up or not. So, okay guys, we'll be back in about 15 or 20 minutes. All right guys, I'm back. It's been about 30 minutes. The garage feels quite a bit warmer. It's a lot more cozy in here than it was 30 minutes ago. You can feel the heat blowing out from this. So considering its size and that it's a 1500 watt heater, I'd say this thing did basically what I expected it to do. My garage isn't overly hot, but it definitely warmed it up. And I'd imagine, you know, I leave this on a little bit longer and it's just gonna get warmer and warmer in here. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Like I stated earlier, please make sure that you read through the owner's manual in its entirety before you operate this, just to make sure that you're aware of all the safety advice and warning and cautions. If you like the video, please like, subscribe, and comment. I do appreciate you guys. Check out my other videos, and have a good one, guys. Thank you.